In this short video, we'll demo some of the core functionality of the AssertThat BDD and Cucumber plugin for Jira. Successful teams who use BDD are the ones who develop a shared understanding of the user stories. It follows that the features and scenarios should be clearly presented and easily accessible to the team. This is where the plugin can help your team by bringing together the user stories and scenarios in one place. Jira. When the plugin has been enabled, as we showed you how to do in the last video, you can now see that the Features tab has been added to the left-hand navigation. This is the first place that the Cucumber or BDD scenarios can be documented from within the plugin. Having selected the Features tab, what we'll do now is import some feature files to get started. Simply identify all your feature files once we import. You can select as many as you like. There we go, features have been imported. In here you also have the option to override the existing. So this is quite useful if you've got a feature file and you change some of the contents and you just want to update some of the details within it. It saves you from having to rename it. To add new features, simply click on the Add Feature button and enter the name and description. Click on Save. Tags can be added at feature or at scenario level. Tags can be used in a multitude of ways to organise your scenarios and features, including grouping them by functionality, testing type, priority, status, test level, and even code branch. For more tips on how to use tags to organise your features and scenarios, please visit our website and the blog Organizing Gherkin Features with Tags, which we will add a link to at the end of this video. A lot of organizations have a high number of features within this page, and so we've added functionality to make it easy to filter by tag and by scenario name. What we'll do now is start to add some scenarios to a feature by clicking on the feature. From within the feature, you can also add background steps, which can be useful if you have some preconditions prior to running the scenarios. So we'll click on the Add Scenario button and start entering the details for our new scenario. So we'll click on Save, and you can see the new scenario has been added. It's also possible to edit the feature from here. It's also possible to edit the feature from this screen. The AssertThat BDD and Cucumber plugin has a few useful features when it comes to writing scenarios, including autocomplete. Simply press Control Space and you get a list of the existing steps to choose from. This is a quick way to add new steps which you know already exist. Using autocomplete ensures that you don't mistype or misspell a step which wouldn't exist in your automated framework. It's also possible to view all of your existing steps by using the toggle autocomplete functionality. Enter at least three characters and you can view all of the steps which contain your keyword and then simply drag and drop them across like that. Click OK. And we're just going to tidy up this scenario here to get rid of these additional steps that we don't want. Within the editor, you can also format the scenario to make it easier to view. This is done by simply pressing Ctrl, Alt and L. You can also set the status of the scenario to manual or automated. You will see later in this video that for manual scenarios, you can set the scenario status to passed or failed from within the issue view alongside the user story. Automated scenarios can be downloaded from the plugin to your automated test framework, and we will show you how to do this in the next videos. One of the key benefits the plugin brings to teams using BDD is that it allows them to view scenarios and user stories on the same page. Here we can link the scenario to other user stories by typing in the Jira user story name here. You can obviously link the scenario to as many user stories as you like. We are now going to take a look at the user story and link more scenarios to the user story from that screen. Simply click on the Demo 9 button and the link will take you through to the user story in Jira. From the issue view for the first time, you may need to click on the Display Acceptance Tests. You'll only have to do this once unless you choose to hide the acceptance tests in the future. Now you can see the features and scenarios that have been linked to your user stories all in the same screen. This makes it really accessible for the entire team to view what the scenarios are linked to the user story. From within the issue view, it is easy to add existing scenarios to your user story or add new scenarios. To add additional scenarios, click on Select Feature and select the scenarios you would like to add. If the scenario is already linked to a user story, then it will be greyed out. For example, these two scenarios have already been added to this user story, so have been greyed out. The only one that hasn't been added is this one here. To add new scenarios, select Add New Scenario, select the feature you want to add to, and start typing in your new steps. The same step autocomplete functionality is available, so you can reuse your steps easily by simply pressing Control Space after typing the first part of the keyword you are looking for. Select the feature, add in the scenario name, and so on. If you have a large number of scenarios and features against each user story, there are some pieces of functionality to expand and collapse all features or just individual features. This makes it easier to scan through the entire user story and see which ones have been linked. From this view, you can just see the feature and the scenario names. And also, if you want to collapse some of the individual scenarios, you can do that by clicking on the button here. To unlink a scenario, click on the Unlink button. This will remove it from the user story, however, it will still exist in the feature file. If you want to delete the scenario, click on the Delete button, and this will remove it from the user story and the feature file. So to unlink it, click on the Unlink. If you want to delete, click on the Delete scenario, and that will remove it. From within the user story, it's possible to pass and fail the manual tests by simply clicking on the pass-fail component. This functionality is only available for manual tests. The overall status of the tests against the user story can be viewed by clicking on the Test Status button. You can see we've got one failed test, one pass test, one in progress, and zero tests in a no run status. The status of automated tests will get automatically updated when the automated test results are imported. We'll just describe how to integrate your automated test frameworks and import your cucumber.json test results file in our later video on this subject. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like a demo or a free trial, then please get in contact with us at support@assertthat.com or visit our website at www.assertthat.com.